Hi everyone. Let's see today how to regain trust in public transportation. You know the situation as the COVID pandemic has changed the world dramatically. And with the new reality comes new challenges in the way we meet, greet and commute. Hi, I'm your host today. I'm Claudio Fassiotti, the community manager Southern Europe for Milestone System. And I will guide you through this journey with the our Milestone XProtect video management software and the solution that can help you to adapt and create a new normal in the public transportation. We will discuss about how can video technology help your business, how video can impact across the entire journey, and how to increase safety and operational efficiency, of course, using video technology. You know, the COVID-19 has changed the world. The situation is clear to everyone and so on the implication. So how we can regain the public trust and reassure our passenger can get back taking the public transport. Let's see about some challenges that we have today. So basically, which station are the most crowded and when? How do we make sure that the station does not get overcrowded? How do we know when people are getting too close to each other? And now, do we respond to and address people? The solution is the video technology, a situational awareness system, which is essential to ensure safety for passengers and all the staff, of course. And we will also see how the video can optimize operation and improve the passenger experience. We will present 7 video technologies to increase the safety and the efficiency. We will talk about how to identify feverish passengers, how to monitor that passenger wear face mask, how to avoid overcrowding in large station areas, how to communicate clearly with the digital signage. Then we will talk about how to check if the people is lost and then found with the use of the face recognition technology. Then how we can enable social distancing with proximity identification. And we will end this presentation with the last one, which will be how to control people density with people counting. We have here with us Mr. Callum Wilson from iSentry, that will show how we can have benefits from the social distancing and the face mask detection. Please, Callum.
Claudio, thank you very much indeed. And it's really great to be on the MIPS platform and talking about something which is extremely important in the travel industry to get the mobility we require for economic recovery. And we're going to talk about 2 of our compliance modules that will help in that regard, which are sort of mask compliancy. We'll talk about it as we go through the videos, as well as our social distancing tools, which look to do both distancing, but also numbers, et cetera. So Claudia, thank you for pulling this up. What we're really trying to do in terms of our social distancing tool is clearly to do the main paradigm is how close are people? Are they encroaching within whatever the defined distance is? But what we need to do to solve this problem more effectively as well is also to understand the other pieces. So how big is the group? How long has it been there for example? And again, how far are they? These are the 3 key elements. Now, within that, we've also got to understand, are groups joining? Were they a group originally? So in other words, we don't have a social distancing issue if 3 people have always been together. And so what you'll notice here is we're starting to break these down into their requisite groups. We then put the duration of time since the group formed. And again, this allows us to have this second paradigm that we'll drill into. So now we see the distance between the groups. A single person can be classed as a group, right? Or they could be a group together. And as these distances start to get too low, we will alert on those, as well as saying how far exactly do we want that to be. So, of course, different countries would have different requirements from a regulatory perspective. Could be 3 meters, could be 1 meter. It depends. So again, as the video will show, we've now got those two groups joining. We've got the number, the base number, which has been hit, as well as the group joining and being too close to each other. And this is a good example of actually showing them moving towards one another. Until we get to that distance, we will then generate an alert on that distance being breached. We now move to obviously the other extremely important part of one, maintaining safety, but you know, second of all, you know, this is all about trust and mobility, and that is the wearing of masks. And you know, we've looked to build this compliance module to be one, very quick and very accurate, but also to both alert on a mask not being worn at all or a mask worn in a non-compliant manner. In other words, the nose and mouth being exposed to the elements. And both of these we can alert on, and of course we can choose. And as ever, will be delivered, you know, directly through the Milestone XProtect front end, with us generating video from the Milestone system. What we can see, obviously, as we run through these videos, is picking up in, you know, in reasonably crowded areas, which you'd find in the transport section, you know, clearly the case. And what we're going to show is alerting on a non-compliant mask, as you can see there. This is all delivered directly into, as I said, the Milestone XProtect front end, and we can generate real-time alerts. And of course, we could send these on to responders as well as to a control room. What you'll see in the following clips is, again, you know, different examples of part compliant, completely compliant, or completely non-compliant. And this needs to be obviously done and alerted to us, you know, again in real time, but also we're not always going to have perfect cameras. So it's important that we can do this in quite challenging scenery, which you'll see in a second. Ideally, of course, you'd want to do this at a controlled choke point. But again, we can do this intrinsically in the wild and at quite great distance. Now, of course, accuracy will be compromised to a degree, but it allows us to have a very broad view of a of an environment and dig into non-compliance as we see it. This is very quickly just to show you a bit how we can set up the actual system. You know, iSentry is a three-layered system. It really creates a trigger point. It has the deep learning and the compliance to then contextualize that, and then has a logic engine to give you decisions and therefore deliver what needs to be delivered through to the actual controller, responder, or whoever it might be.
Let's go back and talk about to avoid overcrowding in large station areas, but now with using a crowd counting technologies. So basically, we can use this technology to get an overview of the capacity, to know where to take action, and of course to direct the service staff in the right point in the minimum time. This is important to manage density level, as I said, optimize the scheduling and forecasting, minimize the risk of overcrowding, saving cost on training and personnel, and achieve reliable data at low cost. So now it's the turn to talk about Crowd People Counter, the software from Canon, and with us we have Mr. Taiki Takei. Please.
Hello, I'm Taiki from Canon Europe. I'm sales engineer, basically working in London office and taking care about this type of the analytics software product of the video imaging. I'm really happy to join the MIPS again and have the opportunity to join the session. As you can see, Canon is providing people counting software named the Canon Crowd People Counter. It's plugin software for Milestone XProtect. I mean, it's completely so integrated to the Milestone XProtect. That counting the number of the people, having the feature to realize count massive number of the people at once very quickly. With using head-based counting technology, our software can realize accurate counting in the very crowd environment. For example, maybe you can see morning crowd in the station, people walking through in the city, in the many people in the event, or kind of thing. Even in the scene, there is some obstacle to hide subject, human body, or many people overlapped each other to hide body. It has a function of setting area to the count. To count and output result as both number of the counted people and density of human in specific area. And as plugin software, XProtect can use this result as a trigger of alert with following the, this you know, setting. You can see in the setting page in the video. I mean, by using this software, you can monitor the how crowded the area is and can make some threshold to take action. We can provide the variable information to do the suitable management in public area, including hall, load, station, or airport. So following the information of the people flow or trend of the crowding, owner can arrange the new gate open, allocated more security guys to suitable place, or plan to total arrangement of control of such huge area. Maybe you can see in the monitor, it's very easy to use. You can set the area to count, and so the immediately the count will run, and so a result is outputted. And you can use this as a threshold to the alert. On the other hand, we can notice illegal gathering of people in the some point of the public area, in the station or public area in the city. You can notice the suspicious move of flow of people automatically. It is also contribute to general surveillance together with Milestone XProtect. And also together with that, you can use this information as a trend. You can set the schedule of the counting in the software, and the people counting is run automatically in the specific time of the week or monthly or kind of thing. And you can gather the total information as a trend. And you can use this and analyze the people flow in the city or public area, and you can control the suitable management for the city surveillance or public safe. As I explained, so the it's totally integrated to the Milestone XProtect software. So you can see the setting button in the downside of the window, and you can set some alert setting in here, setting page. You can set some threshold to send alert to the Milestone alert server, alarm server, and you can see the some event or alarm notification in a Milestone alarm alarm list. Thank you very much for hearing.
Another point which is extremely important is how to communicate clearly through the digital signage. I mean, we are collecting a lot of data, but we need to use those data in the better way. So in a better way, it means we can deliver messaging immediately through the integration between Milestone XProtect and the digital signage software. So the video management, we are using the video management software as a core solution to empower those video messaging. And doing that, it's important to react in real time and to inform the passengers or the employees to prevent unnecessary risk and be clear about guidelines, which is very important for safety reason and for security reason. And of course, reduce the number of staff needed. It's an important part to save cost. So let's see now how the digital signage can really be a very good benefit integrated with Milestone XProtect, thanks to Mr. Bjorn Pieper from NDS Pads 4. Please, Bjorn.
Thank you very much, Claudio, for having us here at the MIPS 2021. And it's a pleasure to present to you the added value digital signage can give to the Milestone XProtect environment. And what we've been seeing so far is people gathering information and gathering data, seeing if people are wearing masks, if the temperature is not too high, too low. But how do you convey this information onto the public? Because the overall goal is, of course, to keep and giving back faith into the usage of transportation, being it in an airport, being it in the bus, in the metro. So detecting is one, but using the information is a second. So what we can do is we can actually utilize, in many cases, existing environments and enrich it with the data that is coming from the Milestone backend. in order to provide a solution that can inform, but also help to prevent and react on situations after things are being detected. And that is what we call social safety signage, the concept around that. So if you look, for instance, at an airport environment, then utilizing cameras, we can detect iSentry as an example, can detect the temperature. We get the information and we inform not only the staff, but also the passengers to go into a certain queue to get a secondary examination. Or if we have detected that somebody is not wearing a mask, we can inform them at the moment this incident is taking place about the wish we have as an organization that you wear your masks. And the same goes in every aspect, being it in airports, being it in the retail environments of the airports, being it in the metros, in the buses, keeping people informed about the social distances that are important at that particular moment and act on that, inform them. So in this example, if the distance should be 2 meters and it's over or below that particular threshold, then it's not just flagging something in red, but we actually make people aware about the fact that certain regulations are in place. And of course, the beautiful thing is you can also sell this with advertising and opening times, public transportation information. So it's the utilization of data, of social media, the utilization of data coming from XProtect, enriched with advertising, giving a true total experience to the people that are utilizing your public transportation. And this is what we want to provide. And we've been providing for the last 25 years in many, many industries. So no matter if you want to utilize it for your transportation or your shopping malls, it's knowing what is taking place, informing people and acting on it. And that is the overall vision we have as NDS on the current situation and what we want to do. Another typical example. Typically seen, wayfinding is something which is static. But nowadays, washrooms need to be cleaned. You want to avoid crowd densities. So utilizing signage, utilizing the data that we get from the XProtect environment, we can actually make this wayfinding dynamic. So if the amount of washrooms usage has been too high, we inform people to go somewhere else. If there is a crowd, we steer people around. Getting a safe environment is what's putting back the trust into people. And with PATS 4, we're capable to support you in that.
Let's see now how we can face a problem which is important in a transportation environment. So basically, we are talking about what happens if someone is lost. And thank you to the technology of a face recognition, we can help to identify those people that are missing in real time or even found how to sell in contactless environment due to face recognition technology. With the face recognition technologies, we are able, of course, to detect faces and to put them in a blacklist identification. So it's important then for finding missing people. And also we can use it, we can use the face recognition technology to enable contactless technology for forensic analysis and search over video, which is another important aspect, how to retrieve the data in a very quick way and create statistics about visitor demographics as well. And now it's the turn of Herta, and Herta will present us a real case study in the Madrid bus station. And we have here Mr. Diego Saenz. Please, Diego. Thank you.
Hi. Hello, thanks Claudio. I'm Milestone. We are very happy to be at MIPS. Okay. And one of the best ways to explain how our solution can help is just to explain a case study, as you said, the Madrid bus station. It's one of the biggest bus stations in Madrid. It's a very crowded, so it's very important, and that is important for us to be able to detect and identify lots of people in real time. And in this case, they had a lot of problems of small security problems like pickpocketing, and also they have small burglars. So they decided to cover all the entrance with our system, with face recognition. So they did just to be proactive. They did just to be ready when they detect and identify someone, so they can trigger an alarm to the security guard, and this guy can stop this guy. Okay. Also, they are using it for missing persons. And one of the steps that we think that we can go further, although it's not deployed yet, is something that we could work like to give access to the people, to the train station or bus stations in other projects, but using face recognition instead of the ticket. Besides that, here, as you can see now in the video, we are integrated, fully integrated with Milestone. So this is very helpful for the customer and user, because all the alarms that our system are triggering are sent to Milestone. So this is good, because then with these alarms events, Milestone can create rules so they can start pre-recording, post-recording, and everything. The plugin is an internal plugin, and when we trigger an event, we are sending all the information from that is in our database. We trigger a picture. In this picture, you can see if this is the candidate, and so you can decide it if it's the real identification, also if group he belongs to, the time, the camera. Okay, so with this information, you can start pre-recording, post-recording, or creating other rules. Also, in this, with this integration, the good thing is the end user or security guard is capable to have in the same platform all the people that are enrolled in our database. So they can do search, so we can combine the search of the databases, so they can find all the people that it's in the database, plus all the detections and identifications on real time in the system. So they don't need to check two screens. Just one screen is enough, Milestone. So that makes easier the life for them. So just to finish, thanks to everybody. Any information that you need about Herta or the integration, just please contact Milestone people or ourselves, and we'll be happy to help you with any information you need. So thanks a lot, Claudio and Milestone. Okay, we are very happy to be at MIS, as I said at the beginning. Thank you.
Thank you very much to have assisted this presentation, and thank you very much to have participated at this MIPS 2021. Stay safe.